my lovely cancers, how are you guys doing? I hope you guys are doing well. I welcome you back to Solar Tarot. So I'm doing your message from your ancestors as to what your ancestors are really trying to tell you, okay, going forward. And the spread that I'm going to pull out would be very simple. It would be about your energy, a little about your past, and you know what you really need to correlate with both the energies. Then what is your gut telling you, your intuition, your subconscious telling you? What is the advice your ancestors really telling you, and what would be the outcome really? So I'm using the mandala deck, which I really love, and I use this deck particularly when I'm doing spirit guides or ancestors, or you know, when I'm doing profound readings per se. So I'm doing this for my Cancer sun moon rising. Please do watch your thing, okay, and use your inner compass when you kind of connect with the reading. As I seek the help of my masters, guys, ancestors, medical, please be here, blueberry Krishna ji, to support the reading. Some of the messages I need to see for cancers watching, cross watchers, if you're watching it, you know, use your inner compass and take the message. It's a very general reading, it can resonate in whatever dynamic, okay. And guys, I've mentioned it all here that I'm not using Google AdWords, okay. I'm trying to grow the community, minus that. I just understand this. Neither I offer or charge for my readings, okay. I've been doing this for a decent time, and this is how I connect with you guys. So vibrationally, if this resonates, great, do subscribe. That would be your energy exchange. And if it, even if it does not, right, do so. That would be the way you would be spreading joy, peace, happiness around. And I send you that loads and loads, okay. So Cancers, let's see, what do we need to see? All my information is in the description box. Do follow us on Instagram and Twitter as well. There are a lot of channel messages on Instagram that I do, but they're essentially relationship, energy shots, daily tarot readings, soulmate and twin flame readings that I do there, okay. And I post on IGTV the free readings that I do. Oh, they asked me to stop. Cancers, let's see, what are your ancestors telling you? So whoever has Cancer in their chart, this message is for them. Amazing. The core energy that you're in right now is the Buddha of Vajras. That's Akshobhya. I'll explain the card to you. I know these cards are new to you. You will not understand them much. But this is about, you know, Vajras are swords in this deck. So with the Vajras here, it's like you've kind of balanced it. Okay. This is more like that sword where, this is like the Ace of Swords for me, but we'll go forward and see what comes. Okay, what was the thing holding it in the past? Yeah, you've just completed a cycle with the Ten of Double Vajras. This is like something to do with your how should I put it, your emotional wellness, you know. It's to do with that. How are they related, both of them, the Ace and the Ten of Double Vajras? With the Nine of Lotuses, that's like, wow. I mean, see, let me just pull out the spread. They're telling me don't talk right now. We have the Dakini of Lotuses, which is Padmakini, okay. And we have the Nine of Vajras. I'm going to explain this to you, don't panic, okay, Cancers? And then we're going to clarify this with the eighth wheel, okay? In my personal sessions that I take, you know, they're very popular. So we have Tara, you got double protection, my love. The Shakti of Double Vajras, that's the outcome. Your ancestors are telling you that. Loud and clear, they're talking to you. I would like you to have a look at these cards, and then I'm going to just read out what Akshobhya means to you from the book, okay. This is the current energy that you're in right now. So with the Akshobhya here, as I said, you know, the Vajras really are swords in this deck, okay. So when we talk about the sword energy, what we understand, we all know in the regular deck, you know, there are different meanings for different cards, right. So, just give me a second. Let me take out, yeah, Akshobhya for you so that you can understand it. Mm-hmm. So this is about that new direction, that positive thinking, that constructive head that you have right now, okay, that you've developed right now. And you have, I think, kind of dropped all your fears. That is why we have the Tara here at the outcome for some of you, because that's how this works. So Akshobhaya, really, in your current energy, is like someone who's not movable. You're not ready. You have your hands folded, like the divine is offering you the cup and saying, you know what, take it. You're saying, I don't want to take it, because I will only accept, or whoever is coming your way in regard to love, career, general, whichever way this is resonating. You are just saying that, you know, you're very clear visioned. You're just saying that, you know, if this is for my highest good, I'm going to take it. If not, I am not. Because see the elephants in the bottom? You're saying that I am not movable, love, now. You cannot use me, treat me like a tissue and drop me down. You are not allowing that, because you've got the wisdom with you right now based on the experience. And there is some amount of trust that you've gained over the period, the mastery that you've gained over the period, the confidence that you have is heightened here. This is what is your current energy, and that comes with a lot of pain, a lot of baggage that you were carrying, you know, for somebody with the 10 of double vajras. As I said, you know, the double vajras really, you know, represent the cups in this deck. So this is like the water element, wherein you have been like, it's the, how should I put it across? This is like that emotional well-being kind of vibe, which was a concern for you at that time. 10 of cups. Okay, you've been overtly emotional with people, because cancers are like that. They're very nurturing, they're very loving, they're very kind, they love to connect, they bond, they give too much. Okay, but this is also, I see like a group of people together, and you know, there are different people from various signs, but cancers giving their best shot and feeling hurt. So you were very, very taken for granted kind of vibe in regard to emotional wellness. But now you're restoring that balance, because you've got so much of clarity right now. Now with the nine of lotuses, really, if you have a look at this card, such a beautiful card. But if you see the snake here, a little snake underneath, with the nine of lotuses, what this really says is that, you know, you have to kind, nines are about something wherein you are at the edge, right? You are at that point where you've kind of decided, now I understand it. You know, this is like fire energy. So this is like the nine of wands. Like, you've got to guard up now. You're saying, you know what, no matter what, no matter what, I am not pulling it down for anybody. I will not take that chance. I'm not dropping it for anyone, because I see certain amount of deceit, a certain amount of selfishness in people around me, and they want to use me in a certain way, but I am not there anymore, because I have moved on. That is what your energy is right now. And our ancestors are watching, and they're very proud, because subconsciously the Dakini of lotuses here that I have, which is like just amazing, which is like she represents fire, she represents passion, she represents you know, see, she has a lotus in one hand, the snake above. So, and the other hand really is like kind of in a state where she knows it all. Like, you know, I know. Don't try and come and confuse me, and don't try and tell me that this is, you know, how this will be, etc., etc. So you are basically taking the control. You're basically saying, you know what, I understand it all. Please don't come and confuse me. Please don't come and tell me that, you know, this is what I'm supposed to do. Because you're working on yourself very consciously with the Dakini, my cancers. I love the reading cancers. I've got cancer in my chart big. And you are working on the depths of your inner being. You're trying to know you. You're trying to say, you know what, I understand it all. You know how powerful you are. You are rising above. And you are telling people to rise above, because your energy is such. You are trying to help and connect with Amitabha, maybe dealing with Aries, I don't know. There's a possibility, because we see, you know, the air energy here, very loud out. And of course, a little bit of fire that I see. I see Leo. I don't see Sag or anything, but I see Leo. And So with this, this is about knowing what you're supposed to do, how you need to go. You need to balance love, but not just with the eye of the passion, but with the eye wherein you feel connected to the person. Okay, where you know that, okay, you know, it's directly coming from above, from the heaven above. And your ancestors are very proud of you, let me tell you, because they understand that, you know, you're not just adding joy to yourself, you're adding joy to other people's life too. And you're making this journey so beautiful, okay? You're comforting people. You are helping people understand them more. And it's an amazing feeling, and you know that in your heart somehow that you've done good. You've really done good. With the nine of Vajras, you know, as I said, they represent the sword energy, right? So this is about the nine of swords. They're saying that, you know, don't be your ancestors. That's what they're telling you, that don't be in this state. This is behind the veil. Do not be in this state. You don't have to worry, fret. Tomorrow will be taken care of. Be here in the now. Okay? With the ten of double vajras also, the cups. Like, be here now. Don't be here. You'll be all right. Don't come down to this level. Don't fret, don't worry. Whatever has to pan out, see, will any which way pan out. Whatever you may do, whatever you may say, it will work in its own light. And we just have to be in acceptance as to what is going on, you know, around us. And we cannot question it. We should not question it. We can only, be here and not think too much about the future. Just stay constructive. Stay in the good energy, okay? And then the outcome, if you balance it, because that's your core energy and you are able to do that, we have the Tara, which is supreme protection. The Shakti of double Vajras, like the emotional wellness would be double, which is right underneath the 10 of double Vajras. This is 10 of cups, this is double the 10 of cups, and protection attached. So you would be protected so much that you can't even imagine that this is how you are loved. Okay, this is how much they love you. And she's always at the center of the mandala. Okay, and she is the most simple, most sweet, most kind, maybe not the most good looking, but she's the most desirable, kind of energy to have around. She's beautiful inside out. And she represents harmony, she represents balance, she represents protection, she represents oneness. So that's what your ancestors are saying, that, you know, you are protected. You don't have to worry for a thing. You just have to believe in, you know, what is really coming your way, my Cancer. So I'm just clarifying this with the ethereal for you a little more. Wow, I have been getting these dreams, you know, honestly, and they have been really loud to me. Seven of Pentacles, absolutely. Keep doing, keep working, stay in this energy. Don't let anybody distract you with the Seven of Pentacles. Don't let anyone distract you and tell you, you know, you can't do this. You know, climbing the mountain is never easy, but continue to climb is easier, because that's the mindset. King of Cups, your energy. They're clear, they're no nonsense, they understand what they're supposed to do, and they will do it. They cannot, stay in the energy of like, oh, I'll do this today. Because this is not a knight, this is a king energy, okay? The Lovers, Gemini. I'm sure you're dealing with an air sign, and there's something that has been disturbing you. It brought you a lot of happiness, Cancers. But I just think that you've made peace with yourself, and you're saying, you know what, my guard is up. I am not allowing anybody to come down, enter the space and tell me this is how it's going to be. In regard to any other dynamic, it's family or career, the same. Like you continue to doing what you're supposed to do. You're not falling in the trap of people and their energy anymore. With the Dakini, the Shakti and the Nine, let's see what comes. The Star, the Aquarian. Full moon in Aquarius has been really powerful for you, because I think you have that star quality, the star energy to you somehow, for some Cancers, I feel. And you've healed, you've done the work. You've been working on yourself for a good time. 17 years for some, 7 years for some, 10 years for some. The artist. This is someone who's very creative, who's someone who knows and is extremely sensitive, can see things from a perspective that people don't, you know. These cards are like very chromatic and everything. I love them, but they give you very exact messages and they go with this deck that I'm using, the mandala. Okay, so you guys may be very creative, and this is your energy, Chariot, to close with. Super. You could be dealing with an air sign, as I said, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. You could be dealing with you know, a Pisces. I feel you could be dealing with an Aquarius. You could also be dealing with an Aries, frankly. So with the Chariot, your ancestors are really strongly advising you to just continue doing what you're doing. You're supremely protected. You have nothing to worry. Just keep going. Because you will receive emotional wellness, double fold, financial abundance, double fold. So there's nothing to worry in your scheme of things. Okay, so this is what I have for you, my Cancers. If you like the reading, do subscribe to the channel. Even if you don't, please do help us grow. And I shall see you the next time. Until eternity. Bye.